All right, Dorbert. What I'd like you to do today is I'd like you to make us a video we can post going over these mean green battery-powered commercial mowers, the ones we just took on. You know, Patriots is the only dealer in the state of Maine. So just go over some of the service aspects, some of the cool features, and talk about what sets Mean Green apart from the rest of the market today. Just go over what they told us at that sales and service training we just went through. You did pay attention during that training, right? Oh, please tell me you paid attention, Dorbert.
Oh, sure, I can do that, no problem. Of course I paid attention, Rob. That's all I do is friggin' pay attention. Jesus. Yeah, I'll get started on that right away, Bob. No problemo. Alright, so that's what I'll do is I'll go ahead and bring one of those bad boys right here into the shop, and we'll get it up on the lift, and I'll show you some of the cool things about them, because they are wicked cool, and we'll go over a little bit of how to service them, how to take care of them, you know, all that good stuff. So, that's what we're going to be doing today. So, first things first, with any, you know, machinery or anything like that, you want to go ahead and get that hearing protection on. So you want to make sure you protect those listeners. All right, so I got it here in the shop. Hold on. Yeah, go ahead and shut it down so that way I don't have to yell over that engine running. Hopefully you can hear me a little bit better, you know. Big mower like this, they can be pretty noisy, so go ahead and shut it off so you can hear me a little bit better. Alright, so Rob just wanted me to go over, you know, some of the cool things about these mowers. So I guess we'll get that somewhere, so Not quite sure where's that. Yeah, so I figure probably the easiest way to show you some of the service features on these mowers is I'll just go ahead and pretend like I'm going to do a service to it, just like I do, you know, maintenance on any other mower. So we'll just go through that right now. I think that'd be probably the easiest way. You see me all right? This zoomed in far enough? Say, tree mechanic. Pfft. Amateurs. Go ahead and check and see what we're at here for gas in this thing. Make sure it's got enough fuel in it. Gotta go ahead and cut this pad out so nobody knows my password. Alright, so that's a pretty cool touchscreen right there. It controls the whole mower. And you can see right there, it tells you it's got about 30% left in the gas tank. So I'm going to go ahead and top it off with some fresh gasoline, Bob. Got some fresh, clean gas to put in this bad boy. Just gotta figure out where to put the gas in. Let's see. Yep. Well, that's just a cup holder for your beer. Root beer. In the patch room here, gonna get everything together that we're gonna need to service a lawnmower. You're gonna want filters, oil, spark plug, you know, stuff like that. Belts, springs, idlers. All the usual stuff, so, and get started. We got the air filter there. That was pretty easy. I probably ought to change out spark plugs in that thing. So, as you may or may not know, outdoor power equipment does use a variety of different spark plugs. So here at Patriots, we do keep a good inventory of different types of spark plugs. But luckily, you know, when you've been doing this as long as I have, you get to know what machine takes what spot plug. These right here. This pack comes in a pack of four there. So we're going to need three packs of those to cover it. So, yeah. I'm also going to get an oil filter and a fuel filter while we're right here. And then get a couple of quarts of oil. Don't want to forget the oil. Boy, probably want to put a new mower belt on that. At least check that one out. But I'll take a new mower belt with me. Just got to find the right one. Boy, there's a lot of belts there. That ain't even a third of them. But I'm thinking that one's pretty close. I'll stretch it on there. It's close enough. Yeah, I'll make it work. Also, just want to make sure, you know, if you're servicing a mower like this, you check, you know, you got your idler pulleys and you got springs and idler arms, stuff like that. Everything that keeps the belts tight so that it's transferring the power correctly from the engine around the torque curve, velocity, times horsepower. You just want to make sure everything's working right. I think we got everything here that we need. We got my Dunkin', got fuel stabilizer, got the oil filter, got an idler pulley, got oil for the engine, got an air filter, got those three packs of spot plugs, fuel filter, got the mower belt there. And then we're also going to be checking, hydraulic fluid, the drive belt, the transmissions, everything that makes it move, you know, the wheels turn, and, greasing it, all that stuff. You got to make sure that there's nothing caught up in where the belts move, where the idle arms move, all that stuff. Alright, so upon further inspection of the service manual, I found out we ain't gonna be needing this gas because it runs on batteries, bub. Battery powered mower. I guess that's why Rob said that. So just gonna go ahead and take this and just probably shouldn't have done that. Being the, you know, genius that I am, I deduced that since I ain't gonna be putting any gas in it because it does run on battery, means I'm probably not gonna need the fuel filter, and probably not gonna need the air filter either. So, guess we won't be needing those either. But we can go ahead and change out those 12 spot plugs in the V12 Mean Green Mower here. It don't take spot plugs? No spot plugs? Not even one spot plug? Oh. Alright, no spot plugs. This is getting easier. Well, everybody knows that you gotta change the oil and the oil filter, just like in your car, every 25,000 miles, 27,000. 27,400 miles. Every 27,400 miles, you want to go ahead and change the oil and the filter every other time. So, go ahead and climb under this thing and change the oil. No. I guess we won't. Well, what we can do is take a peek in here and check out how the mower belt's doing. Make sure everything's turning good. No sticks, dead grass, anything stuck in there, any foreign debris. I'll make sure that's all out of there. Okay, so you got the front of the machine here, and you're looking here, and as you can see, I actually don't even have a mower belt. Well, those things are just wires coming down. So they're just wires going to each one of these little motors here, running the blades. Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle. Alright, so we ain't got an air filter, fuel filter, oil filter, ain't got no spark plugs or oil in the engine, ain't got transmission fluid, drive belt, mower belt, idlers, springs. We ain't got none of that stuff. I mean, on most mowers we do sharpen the blades, but I'm beginning to wonder, does this even have blades? Does it use lasers to cut the grass? I bet it uses lasers to cut grass. That sounds... dangerous. Well, I guess it's first time for everything. I was wrong. It's still got blades, so we can go ahead and sharpen those. This is that blade sharpener right here. It's just a wheel here that sharpens the mower blade. It might be something best left for us, for the professionals, you know? Because you probably ain't going to have one of these in your garage at home, but... So you can bring us the blades and we can sharpen them right here, but... I just show you, you got to be pretty careful, because when you're using one of these, you get a lot of sparks flying. So, you got to be careful. That's why I got all this, and get that safety first. So I'll go ahead and... Good call. You don't want anything flammable around when you're sharpening mower blades, because all those spats. So. Get rid of my note. I was thinking I'll probably just put a brand new set of mower blades on that. We could get after that, probably. I'm gonna go ahead and find any grease fittings I can find. Well, as it turns out, ain't no grease fittings either. So, a little trick I found is if you want to make it look like you've been working hard when boss comes around, well, you, did not work. Freaking out of grease, Bob. You just taking put a little grease on ya, and then looks like you just take the grease gun and just go a little bit like that, and just go a little, do a little of that. Just do a little of that, and looks like you've been working ahead. Get these kind of weird looking front tires on it that you can see. These tires got a lot of holes in them, so I'm not sure what we do about that, but you can't hold air too awfully well. And I talked about this earlier, but it's still probably my favorite feature of the mower. I've got this touchscreen here. You can go ahead and watch. You can go ahead and watch Netflix on it, and keep up to date on baseball game. It tells you some of the less important stuff too, like what height you're cutting at. And, some of the information on the machine, and, I'd still much rather be watching the baseball game, though, so that's what's important. Safety first, Bob. Yeah, so Mean Green makes quite a few different models, and, we've got a good lineup here at Patriots, so you can see they make walk-behinds, stand-on, and, sit down zero turn mowers like this one here. This one happens to be the Mean Green Rival. I'm pretty sure that's French for wicked fast, something like that. So, Mean Green Rival right here at Patriots. Mean Green Mowers, bud. I'll tell ya. These things are beautiful. You always hear people say, you know, this is a Cadillac of air fryers, a Cadillac of smartphones, stuff like that. But I'll tell ya, this thing right here, this is the Tesla of lawnmowers, bud. Tesla. It's so high tech. But at the same time, it's pretty simple. So, so whether you're a genius like me, or, you know, not quite so smart, you can still run it. You can still work on it. You can still make money mowing lawns with it. Mean Green Mowers, all battery powered, all fully commercial, at Patriot Service Center, Maine's only Mean Green dealer. Route 26, Oxford, Maine. Come check them out, Bob.